My wife, I love her, takes the night. The release is a gluten-free beer. And here we're talking about this stuff. Why did it take 2007 to release the world's first gluten free beer? Obviously, people have gluten on the beer before. The beer made of sorghum, not wheat or barley. And they didn't just go to first to make beer out of sorghum. There's nothing new about that either. And so I interviewed them, and the answer is this. The long-term effect of these problems in the market is actually just a mirror on something broader than that. Which is that as we become more active, convicted as consumers, and better educated and informed about our choices, we become more discriminated. We start to get more refined taste and look at coffee. 20 years ago, there was coffee. Now, in America, we have Starbucks. There are 36 different, 30,000 different varieties. Now, we use the broader now, thousands of different kinds of water. Coffee, we can continue to really coffee. I look at it the other way. I think the rest of the world is catching up to where it really was 100 years ago, 500 years ago. And think about it. A nation defined by small and medium sized companies. A nation with two of the main industries being beer and wine, but also being wine and manufacturing. This has always been thank you.